All right, here's the lag for the second set. Well, if you're just joining us, this is the second set of the finals. Cliff Joyner coming back from the one loss side and defeating Richie Richardson in the first set. And this is set number two, final set.
Side. It looks like there's a lot of action on the other tables going on.
Yeah, Daryl Biggert is here, and he's
playing against Frost right now.
Robert Frost.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a good match.
And Jerry Slifka's got him a match against some banger, a local banger here that's got a lot of tax-free money in his pocket.
Oh man, hey, look, hey, take over here, okay?
Tell me which buttons not to push.
I'm gonna go get in line.
There you go. And he will play anybody.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's not scared.
Cool. Gotta love it. Joyner leave there.
Yeah.
I actually watched Cliff practicing leaving the cue ball up in the jaws like that.
Really?
Just over and over again, hitting the ball out and rolling the cue ball up right in there.
Yeah.
Thank you. What was that the waitress had brought by over here by accident a while ago? Was that beef tips?
That was the beef tips. Yeah, that's pretty good. It's one of the number one sellers here.
Yeah, it looked really delicious. That's one thing that'll go away if the kitchen does, huh?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Brutal.
Yeah, the cook that's here today, he used to work at one of our local Cajun-style restaurants, and so a lot of the red beans and rice and stuff that we have here that he knows how to make from working there. And so the guy that owned that restaurant that he used to work at worked down in New Orleans for quite a long time after he finished culinary school and stuff. So.
And now the woman that works in the back also.
Miss Mama is what we call her.
Yeah, Miss Mama. Now, she used to work at the Hilton, didn't she?
She did, and she actually, that recipe for the beef tips is hers. And she brought over from the Hilton, that's correct.
Yeah. Yeah, good eating.
Yeah, a girl once told me there's two things you can't spend too much money on, good food and good music. Whoops. I think he wanted to get below that nine ball and just hit it.
Rick, you just got to be careful here. You're going to have to let the cue ball go to get enough juice on this.
Yeah,
this
back and forth. Make sure you make it.
Oh, parked it on the stack.
Bad. And his big truck says,
Bad move. Oh, yeah, no love.
No love.
Well, yeah. Or bad move, human.
Okay. Yeah.
Or both apply.
Yeah.
He needed some love on that one.
Definitely.
After this, if he doesn't win this this tournament now, he's going to need a hug.
I just ordered that that CTE video, Center to Edge.
Oh, yeah.
Haven't had a chance to watch it yet, but old Dwight Anderson here was telling me that it's really, you know, it's got a lot of knowledge in it and things that you really wouldn't realize.
Yep, good stuff. Another program that Perfect Aim, Gene Albright, complements the CTE as well.
When I first started playing, one of the guys in the pool hall when I hung around at Van Winkle, Ben Brownstein, he let me borrow a Grady Matthews instructional video, which I still have. It's on VHS, believe it or not. But
cool.
Every now and then I'll watch it, and it's about 6 hours long.
I mean, transfer it over to DVD because they don't last forever.
Right, yeah. But I always tell people that Grady Matthews taught me to play.
Yeah. Yeah, Grady will definitely be missed. Oh, he is missed already.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have the inaugural Grady Matthews Memorial Tournament.
Memorial Tournament.
Yeah, coming up in September.
So that's in North Carolina?
South Carolina.
South Carolina.
Yeah, Lexington.
Gotcha. Everybody staying away from that table so much, I hate to go over there and nonchalantly walk by and look in the two holes. But
oh no, I'll just ask Cliff.
Yeah.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna check it out. Hold the fort down.
Gotcha. Don't push this button. That was nice.
Now this is that we did update the scoreboard from the rail too, so best we can figure out there. Richie's got one and Cliff's got the rest. Shot.
Nice.
Cliff wanted to bank this five from the beginning here, and he just had to calculate how, if he could hold the cue ball over to the right side of the tables. He doesn't want to sell the 14 ball here. I'm not sure what he's going to do, actually. Oh, yeah, look at that. He just made sure he got that cue ball over where Richie wouldn't be able to make anything. Nice shot. Richie protected the cue ball behind the stack there and forced Cliff to have to one rail kick at this two ball.
A nice shot if he played the five off the stack on purpose.
Thank you.
came a little bit far there. I don't know if you can see the four ball. If he does, he should have natural shape for the 14. That's nice. Just missed that side popping good shot. Looking to play the 14 and try to set up shape to bank the 15.
We got action.
Hit it a little hard.
Time. It gets kind of chilly in this corner over here.
Yeah, the vents blow right over here. Surprised as hot as it's been that they haven't shut down on us. Oh, he was able to see that 15, but got the bad kiss.
They don't even say that about the air conditioners.
He got lucky, and maybe if Cliff can't see it when it spots.
So did Richie make that?
He made it in a wrong pocket, but it looks like his Cliff's got a clear shot on it.
There we go. Okay, thanks.
If he makes this, he should be out for the 7. This will be the first time that Cliff is, I don't want to jinx him. He's always gotten second in our tournament anyway.
Right, let's say it. Bite your tongue. He seems determined this time.
I think so. He's got nobody to borrow a hundo from.
I'm going to hit him up for a hundy if he wins.
There he goes.
There it is, Cliff Joyner.
Cliff Joyner.
Gets the first rack, and all he needs is one game to win the tournament. Richie needs two. Richie's break. Now watch, he's going to break from the right side. Every time they break, they switch sides.
Do they? Like the individual person you're saying switches sides.
Yeah, everybody wants to take the left side of the table for the pocket.
Well, I know the right pocket, if you're slow rolling down that rail, it'll drift about a half inch towards the center of the table. And it'll start between the second and last diamond.
That could be why they're avoiding that side there. So winning that flip is huge here then, if they get to pick which side they break from first, because if it goes hill-hill, they get to break it again. Pick the side. Huge advantage. So maybe that's why everyone's been lagging. They have to lag now, so.
Right, instead of flipping the coin.
Here we go. Very nice break.
That's a good break there.
Sure was. Cliff surveyed the rack here for a dead ball, and I don't see anything myself.
No, if he can move that 9 over his side, I think. Maybe hit into the 3.
five. Oh,
yeah, that's what he did.
Wow.
That was a great shot right there. I don't care who you are.
Gotta love it. Man, I want to see that over. I wish I had a replay on that one.
It's another dagger that Cliff thrusts into your heart.
That's a 12-2 almost looks like it might go off the four ball. I'm not sure. Maybe I even go straight in.
Might.
He's going to two rail this one ball. No, maybe not. I forgot to tell the players to think to the side.
he did.
Yeah, he did. Okay. I didn't even see it. And I tell you what, I'm never coming over here again with one camera on the one pocket.
How many do you have total?
Four. I'm trying to add another one. I want to be getting a different kind of camera for doing shooting little special interest videos at the tournaments, and I want to get a hard drive cam where I can slide them over on the computer and show them during the show real quick. Shot, Richie Richardson on the board. And he's off to the races. He has a wide open table here. So this is set to go hill and battle it out to the last ball.
He got it. Oh, cue ball moved out just in the nick of time.
I feel like I missed a ball, Zach.
I don't think you did. He just, you're up. There's one that he knocked in the top corner.
Okay, so that's one of them. I'm still missing one because there's 10 on the table.
Oh, you're right.
So. Had to have been Richie, because...
Mm-hmm.
We're going to see about what action we've got going on after the tournament here. We will have a bonus segment with action. So if any of you would like to stick around, see what we can... muster up, please do so. That was a good shot.
Well, I've got that one match of Jerry Slifka playing the local guy named Emmanuel.
Oh, yeah?
Emmanuel's getting 11-5, 12-5. They're playing $500 a game.
Nice.
And Daryl Biggert and Frost.
Oh, that's Robert Frost, too.
Robert Frost, I'm sorry.
Yeah, not Scott Frost.
Right. That's why I did say Frost. I wasn't sure. From what I'm hearing, they're playing even for 50 a game.
Nice.
Daryl's up one game.
Okay. Well, Daryl Biggert, always in action. He's an action man. Blade by day, action by night. Great shot.
That was a good shot.
Man, look at this. He's got the two ball.
Not on the diamond.
Look at this now. Cliff really didn't have a shot.
He doesn't.
That 13 ball was over just a hair more.
He could back cut the 7.
Well, so that's a 15, actually. Oh, back cut the 7. Get out of here. Take a break? What's going on, right?
Not sure.
Well, we're going to see if we can find out what is going on here. They must be on break real quick. And I guess while we're waiting. Take a break. Cliff Joyner coming back in now, getting a little manual air dry working on his hands there, and he is ready to take this on. tough situation here because that two ball is in a really bad spot for Cliff, especially without being able to make anything. He's really looking at this 15 ball. It might go. It might go.
I just got the scoop on the action tables. Slifka is playing Manuel. Manuel's getting 411 for 500. And Daryl and Robert Frost are playing even for 200 a game.
Cool. Was Daryl up one still? Or?
I'm not sure. He was when I went over there the first time.
Well, what kind of reporter are you, Zach?
A non-intrusive reporter.
Supposed to go over there and tap him on the shoulder and say, hey, listen, we need some info.
Yeah, it always aggravates me. Yeah, he's going for the combo, isn't he? Look at this. What was he doing?
Man, that was as Grady Matthews would say, fraught with peril.
You know, one of the things that struck me funny whenever I started watching that Grady Matthews video was he would shoot the shot, and as he was shooting it, he would say, and it should go right to the hole, and it did every time. Just amazing.
That's hilarious. Rouch. Now, I'm not sure. I'm not sure Richie has a shot here. Maybe Cliff knew something a little more than us here. Because, I mean, it looked like he sold out. Richie gets one out of it. Richie's on right now. No, here he is. He was studying. Nice shot.
That's a good shot. Is he going to try to tighten it up? No.
Put it behind the 12. Yeah. Nice shot. That was pretty good. In case any of you are just tuning in, this is Ray Hansen, your host, also known as Big Truck, and I'm here with Zach Boyd from the Green Room in Jackson, Mississippi. We're watching the finals and the second set of the finals of the one pocket division here. Nine ball is going to start about noon tomorrow with the players auction. It will be free to watch the players auction. Anyone can tune in and check it out. And we'll need your password after the players auction begins, or ends, excuse me, ends. Nice shot right back at Cliff there. Issues here is Cliff can't kick the six out of there because the 15 ball bank sitting right there.
Yeah.
So now he could bank the 15 out and put the cue ball over behind the six ball. Oh, he's going to roll up and leave it long.
He's going to take a foul.
No, he hit it in the rail. He did take a foul. Sorry. I got to start getting more than 4 hours of sleep here.
It helps sometimes. Talking about, you've got next 5 weeks, or in September, you've got five straight weekends of tournaments and stuff going on. And you know, for people who really watch this live streaming and stuff, and you know, you pay the day of the finals, the little bit that it is, you know, by the time you end up watching everything for September, if you'd gotten your year-round premium package, you know, you really save money.
Yeah,
I mean, because you're spending just, you know, $50 for that 1 month, and you can get a whole year's worth for,
right?
You know, it's a really good deal.
Well, you know, some of the bigger shows are actually, you know, it's just the smaller regional events we'll do a Sunday only on a pay-per-view. But,
right.
But Cliff is going to throw a ball now. The premium membership is going to have a slight price increase also after August 15th. Any of you that are on the fence on getting one or need to renew yours, it'd be a good time to do it before August 15th. The pricing is going to go to quarterly is going to be $50, and the 6 month is going to go to $70, and the annual will go to $120. Just we're booking so many shows. It's this is crazy. If anyone listening out on the internet knows of any events in December, December is usually a brutal month for Big Truck here. And of course, you know, it's Christmas month.
Right. Yeah.
And we've been trying to save up, you know, knowing that it's coming. But if we could get some events in December. Or if anyone's interested in having a pre-Christmas event, those usually do pretty good, too. I'd be interested in covering those.
I think our last tournament was the first weekend of December of 2011.
Really?
We had 20 in the one-pocket event and about 50 in the nine-ball. I think Richie's got three balls there, Ray. They just took some fouls.
Okay.
Nice shot.
It's going to take Cliff back to zero.
Yeah.
Time. Man. He hit it so good, it was bad.
Like one of my back cuts.
the son of a preacher man myself.
Are you really?
My dad was a Pentecostal preacher.
Oh, yeah.
Also was president of the Full Gospel Businessmen Association. Hmm.
Go to Chick-fil-A this past Wednesday?
Every chance I got.
Yeah.
I eat there all the time anyway.
Yeah, they have good stuff. Anyway.
It was just a better excuse for me to go and eat again.
Right.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I was a black sheep of the family.
Well, but my mom always tells me I'm her favorite child. And she only has one child. Yeah.
My mom used to tell our son that he was her only grandson, and you know, my sister has a son, so
oh, really?
He would be in the room too.
That's hilarious.
We think that might have been some of the early dementia setting in.
Right.
Richie's got two here. I think that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's it.
Hill match.
We got action.
Awesome. That's what we like to see.
And guess who's breaking? Mr. Cliff.
See if he'll do better than his last break.
How big was that lag?
Oh my gosh, really?
Checked out the Billiard Pro Shop catalog, ask for it at your local pool room. They've got an awesome assortment of billiard supplies, and they're adding more all the time. David up there, one of the owners, great guy, great people that run it out of Lakeland, Tennessee. But they primarily service pool rooms throughout the world, really. Any pool room anywhere can have access to that.
Where is Lakeland, Tennessee?
It's just outside of Memphis.
Oh, okay.
All right, players are taking a break. And, I guess we'll take a quick break as well. We'll be right back, folks.
You have a real good selection down here at Emerald Billiards. Of pool tables, whatever you want to play on. Whatever your table, you got it down here, you know? And also in Emerald Bay, you have the full bar, where you have a full kitchen. We serve anywhere from finger food to steak dinners every night. We're known for our Emerald Burger. You can really enjoy yourself down here. If you want to come out and just shoot pool with your family one night, or you want to come out here and gamble, you'll find a game over here anytime you want.
See that impressive kick shot there. thought he could sneak that one through there. No love. Get that scoreboard back up. It is 2-0 on the ball count. Hill, Hill, last rack here. Last rack of the tournament, second set of the finals. Cliff Joyner came back from the one loss side and won the first set. Now this is set number two, and it's all tied up. Cheeseburger here.
I just got the update on those money matches. Manuel and Slifka are even, and Daryl Biggert is 4 games down.
Yeah.
that does have one ball raised is using the computer right now and haven't been able to score. But it is 1-3. Wow, that's great. That's a freaking nice shot right there.
Cliff Joyner. Oh,
beep.
Where'd he go? He hit that so good he had to take a break.
He didn't believe it himself.
I mean, that's not it, is it?
No.
Okay. Checking the score. I don't know what they're checking down there.
I don't think they do either.
Hopefully. This is one of those deals. I hate this makes me so nervous. I keep worrying somebody will come by and you know, move the balls or something. I mean,
right, yeah.
Put a stick out there at least so people know there's a game going on here.
Didn't that happen with Daryl Biggert? Had a side action game going on and supposedly he was in a trap, so he sent one of his buddies over there to start banging the balls around while they were on break.
Yes, it did happen.
That was about 3 weeks ago or something like that, wasn't it?
Yeah. I can't remember what the remedy was. It seemed like they played the game over or something.
Oh, no. I told his cousin Chris Biggert that, and he said, oh, that sounds like Daryl.
Take a break, man.
Really?
I'm sweating this. I don't even know why. I guess this thing, it seems like it'd be cool for Cliff to win one finally over here.
Oh, I guess that was it.
No? Or is it?
Well, I guess so.
I hope so.
Well, Cliff won.
Oh, All right, that is it. We would have been waiting for a while.
I guess so. Yeah. Put the clock on them.
Yep, it's over. Richie Richardson just confirmed with us here that it is over. So.
Yeah, Cliff Joyner won his first one pocket tournament here at the Green Room. Finally,
awesome.
Getting him in second place.
Oh, Mr. Cliff. Well, we're going to see what kind of action we got going on over here. We might keep things rolling here if we get something interesting happening. And it's most certainly something interesting is going to happen. So stay with us, folks. Real quickly, the payouts for the tournament there. First place was $900. Second place was $450. Third was $270. And fourth was $180. 16 players, so we did get the 1,000 added. Players auction, $650 for first and $350 for second, and that was 100% payback, and 1,000 added to 16 players, so that was great.
Yeah, that was a good little match there at the end. I enjoyed that.
Yeah, me too. Tip my hat to Truett Hawkins for putting up the added money here and inviting us all out for the one pocket here. We'll be back with nine ball action tomorrow around noon. The players auction will be free to watch. Then we will need your password after the players auction. We'll probably give it 30 or 40 minutes like normal. But anyway, again, we're going to stay on. And
yeah, Truett's pretty good about, you know, even if you don't have 16 players, he'll still add that $1,000. And same thing on the nine ball side. If, you know, there's not a full roster or whatever, he'll still throw in that money. He's, you know, he likes to have these players here and have these events here and stuff like that. So
exactly. Well, you know, ever since I've been covering them, we've had more than 16 every time.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, usually around 20, 22, mm-hmm. Something like that. So that's awesome. And again, we're going to see what kind of action is going on. We're going to find out some updates possibly on the game with Robert Frost and.
Last I checked, Daryl Biggert was four games down.
No kidding.
And they were playing even.
Oh, man. Wow.
200 again.
Ricky and Scott. I don't know. Action's been pretty good over here.